Speaking from Brazil, US President Barack Obama says it was clear that Allied forces had to protect civilians in Libya. Let's get more now from RT's Gayane Chichakyan. She's in Washington, D.C. Gayane, take us through Washington's reaction to this.
Well, Bill, a full-scale military intervention is underway. The leaders who got together in Paris were very resolute about it as they were talking. French warplanes were already in the air over Libya, and then we got some first reports of attacks on Gaddafi's ground forces. We know that British fighter jets are on standby in Cyprus, ready to take off, and U.S. warships are in the Mediterranean. Missile strikes from those ships are very possible. What Hillary Clinton reiterated after this meeting in Paris is that there will be no U.S. troops on the ground, but fears are that this operation could grow into something more than just an effort to protect civilians. The wording of the resolution that was passed on Thursday is basically all inclusive, short of occupation. It says all measures allowed in order to protect civilians. When the resolution was approved, Russia and China did not use their power to veto it, providing that there will be no occupation, meaning no boots on the ground. The priority is, of course, protecting civilians. When Gaddafi basically promised the massacre in Benghazi, he left the international community with no choice. Even those countries that are very much against any military intervention, like Russia, abstained from voting against the resolution, but there are still strong worries as to the implementation of it. There are fears that certain actions taken by international forces that are taking part in the operation could destabilize the situation even more. Shooting down Gaddafi's fighter bombers is one thing, and of course that would be part of the no-fly zone measures allowed by the resolution, but arming the rebels is something very different, and reports are coming in. Egypt's military began shipping arms over the border to Libyan rebels with knowledge from Washington, of course, because the Egypt's military is very much influenced by Washington. Those are small arms such as assault rifles and ammunition. Experts say that there are radical elements among those rebels as well, and they are unlikely to show mercy for their opponents. And the fear is that those arms supplies are going to inflame the situation in the region even further.
Gayane, throughout events in Libya, many would say the U.S. has really been sitting on the fence, in some ways letting other countries, France, Britain, do its dirty work for it. I mean, is that a fair comment?
Well, Bill, from what Obama was saying on Friday and what Hillary Clinton was saying this Saturday, you could tell that the White House is wary of being seen as the driving force behind the military actions. So most of the work is done behind the scene. The UK and France seem to be on the forefront of this international effort. Also, Western powers again and again remind that they have the support of the Arab League, although at the moment it's not quite clear what their input will actually be in this action. But it is clear that they want to get Arab countries' assistance, so that it doesn't appear as if it's just the West cracking down on yet another Arab nation. There's one more thing that's worth talking about. It's almost never mentioned in the media coverage of the developments in Libya. Gaddafi is universally, but Daniel just previously talked about it, touched upon it a little bit. Gaddafi is universally denounced for his actions against the Libyan people, that's for sure. The international community is absolutely united in condemning him for a good reason. But when you think about other leaders who got away with attacks on civilians, you see a great amount of hypocrisy in the way those leaders are treated. Let's take Israel, for example. It had been bombing the civilian population of the Gaza for 3 weeks in a row in 2008. Western powers, who are now so up in arms protecting civilians in Libya, did nothing, literally nothing, to stop the massacre of Palestinians in Gaza. Or we can take a look at the recent developments in Bahrain. The leadership there is cracking down on protesters in a terrible way. Scores are dead, and there is no tangible international effort to stop it. Yemen, same story. Yemen troops shoot protesters dead and nothing. Or Pakistan, just this Friday, a U.S. drone killed 38 civilians there. Will anyone be responsible for that? Analysts say, as things are now, it looks like the international community is very selective when it comes to protecting civilians. In Libya, they protect them. In dozens of other places, they turn a blind eye.
Gayane, thanks very much indeed for that update there from Washington, D.C. RT's Gayane Chichakyan there.